Anybody dance? I obviously was busy. I can pay attention. Well, here's another one. Here's a pop. This was actually a popular tune back in the 70s. It was first done by the Animals. How many remember the Animals, the rock band, the Animals? It's probably their most, their best known tune, and it's actually a waltz. Here's a House of the Rising Sun.
Thank you.
So for everyone, anyone here who was born after 1990, see, we had some cool music too. And actually, speaking of some cool music, the next thing selection we're going to play for you is a suite from probably the most popular Broadway show in the last two years. We're going to play some music for you. Here's the suite from Hamilton. How many of you saw the show when it was here? Raise your hand. Boy, did you miss something. I'm sure it'll be around again.
Thank you.
you very much. Our next selection is Shenandoah, and I know you recognize the tune, but this is just a wonderful arrangement written by Frank Cicchelli about almost 20 years ago, I think it is. About 20 years ago. And it's actually written as a memorial to a French horn player, young boy of 13, excuse me, who passed from cancer. And this was commissioned for him.
Thank you.
our next selection. This one actually comes from a cartoon movie, an animated movie, called An American Tale, about an immigrant mouse. Here's Somewhere Out There.
Thank you.
Now, just so you get an idea of the difference in styles of Sammy Nestico's compositions, we're going to play a march for you. And as I said earlier, he was an Air Force veteran, but he conducted the Marine Corps Band. This next march, he actually wrote for the Marine Corps Band. Here's the Silver Quill. Thank you. Our next selection, a fun march. I'm surprised nobody got up and started marching around. Next time we do this, I'm going to suggest that before we play the tune. We're going to continue on with a wonderful Bill Holcomb arrangement from, this is Lady Sings the Blues. Thank you. Thank you. Our next selection was actually, well, not written by this young lady. It was certainly became famous when she sang, when Karen Carpenter sang it. Here's Rainy Days and Mondays. Calvin Custer was a wonderful arranger, chief arranger for the Syracuse Symphony Orchestra. He was also the assistant conductor. One of the interesting things about Calvin Custer was that he was hired as a second French horn player in the orchestra there. But he also initiated the Syracuse Symphony Rock Ensemble. He was the lead guitarist. He wrote the arrangements. He's a fabulous jazz and rock piano player and bass player on top of all of it. And he was a wonderful arranger. We're going to play for you his arrangement of Scarborough Fair. Actually, it's titled The Variations on Scarborough Fair. And for those of you who probably thought that Scarborough Fair was originally written by Simon and Garfunkel, Paul Simon actually wrote the words to it, but the theme from Scarborough Fair itself actually goes all the way back to the 11th century. Here's Variations on Scarborough Fair. Well, it's after 8 o'clock, so I guess we're done. All right, I suppose we can keep going. Here's a wonderful, it's not exactly a march, but it's a wonderful piece of music that's in the march style, written by a composer by the name of Keith Foley, who was actually a trumpet and composition major in the Eastman School of Music back in the 70s. It's just one of his wonderful pieces of music he wrote for school music programs. This one's called Jubilance. Thank you so much for coming out. We have one more number for you. And I noticed nobody came up to dance, so I guess you're out of luck unless you can dance to a march. Here's the Stars and Stripes. Thank you.